All right, we're troubleshooting a Whirlpool-built, it's Kenmore branded, but Whirlpool-built dishwasher today. The complaint is that there's no heat. The heated dry cycle has stopped working on this dishwasher. So what you want to do, something like that, first thing you look at the schematic and see what's involved. Our load of interest is the heating element right here. Let's blow that up a little bit. Sorry about the background noise. But there's our heating element, and we've got a high limit. These are in series. We can conveniently test both of these from the board without having to disinstall, do any other further disassembly of the dishwasher, other than just gaining access to the board right there. And it turns out that for this harness connector, that's this guy right here that I've got disconnected, that is the P4 connector that you're seeing right here. So all we're gonna do is we're gonna measure resistance from P4.3 to P4.4, and we're looking for something at 8 to 30 ohms in here. I'm not normally a big fan of resistance checking, but this is a very convenient test to do here just to rule out and sort of half split the problem. Do we have a problem in this circuit itself, or is it a problem with it, the circuit not being energized? And that's what we're going to check right now with a measurement. Okay, so P4.3, P4.4, that's these two blue wires right here. And so I'm just going to back probe. I've got it disconnected from the board. I'm just going to back probe these two to make a good connection. And let's look on our meter, make sure my probes are in there good. And we're getting about 14 ohms. That's right in spec. Let's come back up here to the, that's right about what we should be reading, right? The closed high limit should be essentially zero. And then our heater spec is anywhere from 8 to 30 ohms. So there's nothing wrong electrically with this heating circuit. So now the question becomes, why aren't we getting voltage? And there's no voltage to push electrons through the circuit and make things heat up. And one other thing going on here, notice in this strip diagram, they also include it with the OWI sensor. And we have, that's the optical water indicator sensor here that we're gonna check. It's also got a thermistor in here. If that thermistor is lying to the board, then the board will take a bad input and it won't heat up the, won't fire up the heating element. So we're gonna, when they give us a spec right here, about room temperature, we should be getting about 46 to 52 K ohms across these two pins, P12.3 to P12.1. So we're going to measure the, and that's this yellow connector right here. All right, so we're going to come along here and measure from P4 pin 1 to pin 3. That's this first one and then the second one over. They're all yellow, so you just got to count. And we're just going to do the measurement right in the back here. We've got some openings right here and see what we're getting for resistance across the NTC thermistor that's built into that OWI sensor. All right, so here we are, we're on it right here, 1 to 3, and now look at our meter. 47 K ohms, that corresponds to about 77, 78 degrees, which is about the temperature that we're dealing with right here. As far as I can tell, given with the information given, our thermistor is in spec, so it's not lying to the board. The board is simply, at this point, the problem seems to be the board is not energizing this circuit. So we're in the step of the self-diagnostic cycle where we are actually running the heater. We've advanced that. Notice our light configuration. We have normal, heated dry, and start. That's what should be lit. We should be getting 120 volts, and we are. That's our harness connector for the heater. But, and the other thing we need to check, though, is current. And I'm doing that here, 7.3 amps through that circuit. That circuit is working. The problem, apparently, is that it's not initializing on its own. It's doing it in self-test, but it's not doing it in normal run mode, and there's no reason the NTC and the OWI was in spec, so that wouldn't be a cause for it. So it's just a failure of the board to initiate the water heat cycle in a normal mode that the customer would use. So how did I wrap this up with the customer? Well, first of all, I told them that we found, since we found no problem because all the parts tested in spec, then there was no warrant to replace any parts at this time. Right? You only replace a part if it tests bad. You have some evidence that it's bad. We didn't have any evidence whatsoever. So I told them to keep using the dishwasher. And then we followed up with the customer a week later, and guess what? He said everything was working properly, the heating cycle, all was okay. Question is, why? What's going on here? How come it wasn't working for him, and customers won't call if, unless there's a real problem, and yet it worked for us? We've got three potential troublemakers in this scenario. One is that the NTC thermistor is intermittent, could be going out of spec, or even open at higher temperatures. I've seen this before, particularly on Whirlpool appliances, like a dryer that used a thermistor would work fine at room temperature. As it heated up, it would open. Same thing could be happening here. This thermistor was right here in the OWI, the optical water indicator sensor. They give us two specs, and we only tested it at room temperature. Now, really, a good test on a thermistor, you get two data points, but the other thing, when you're doing the self-diagnostic test like we were, it's testing already the thermistor at the higher temperature and then reporting back via an indicator on the panel what the status is. So that we had no other indications from running self-test or our measurements that the thermistor was a problem, though it could be. That's a potential. One of the potential troublemakers is it could be going intermittent. One of these heater relays, you'll notice on the strip chart here that the heater element here uses two relays. One they call out as K3, that's in line 1. The other one they call out as K1, which is in the neutral side. Right, here's the neutral side of the heating element. So, right, L1 and neutral. And so either one of these relays could be mechanically sticking. The contacts can arc and it can stick. When it's time for it to change state from one contact to the other set of contacts, it could be sticking. That's a potential problem. If we're talking about in the realm of potential troublemakers, well, that's certainly one of them, just a mechanical, pending mechanical failure of one of those relays. Again, no telling if that's really what's going on without disassembling the relay, looking at the contacts, and right, nobody's going to do that. It could be that there was a board logic problem, and the logic could be temporarily altered by a power glitch. This will happen on your desktop computers, for example. If you're using it plugged directly into the wall outlet without any kind of filtering, there could be a glitch in the line, causes all of your computer to all of a sudden act strange or give you the blue screen of death. You have to reset, reboot, or in this case, when we reset, just going into service mode resets the machine. It's designed to do a warm reboot when you go into service mode on this particular board. So it's entirely possible that by us simply doing the technician thing and talking to the board, putting the board into service mode, and by doing so causing the board to reset or reboot, that we cleared the problem. There was maybe no real problem, maybe neither one of these conditions existed, but we did in fact have some sort of temporary logic problem. So, in either event, doing this appears to have solved the problem, and we didn't have to replace any parts to arrive to that conclusion. Learn how to troubleshoot like a real technician at mastersamuraitech.com. Basic electricity, circuits, reading schematics, using schematics as a troubleshooting tool, and the basic technology that's common to all appliances, we teach you this at mastersamuraitech.com. Online, on demand, 24/7 appliance repair training.